underrated players. There's lots of them in the NHL, and these are players who I think aren't appreciated enough for what they have accomplished this season. And in today's video, we're going to be narrowing it down to 5 players who I really think should get a lot more credit for what they have accomplished this NHL season. You think about the Philadelphia Flyers, and you immediately think about Claude Giroux and Jakub Voracek, the two faces of that franchise at this time. But in my opinion, Sean Couturier is a huge, massive part of this team, and they wouldn't be as good as they are right now without him, and take a look at these stats that prove it. Sean Couturier has been a beast this year. He played in all 82 games, and he had 31 goals and 45 assists for 76 points, and the best part is he's only 25 years old, and he has so much room to grow and could potentially become the next face of the Philadelphia Flyers franchise. But right now, the thing that is holding him back from being appreciated by everyone around and that likes hockey is that he plays under the shadow of Claude Giroux and Jakub Voracek, and he does not get enough credit for what he does. Couturier was a first-round pick, 8th overall, so it's not like he was a late bloomer or just a late pick in the draft. Usually, people that are drafted this high get hyped up and they have a lot of people talking about them when they have really good seasons because they're expected to. But Sean Couturier is an exception to that because he plays behind such great players, and you could look out because sometime soon, Sean Couturier could be coming to be the next face of the franchise and take that spot from Voracek and Giroux. Scoring 40 goals in the NHL is no easy task, and the players that did it this year was Alexander Ovechkin, Patrick Laine, William Karlsson, Evgeny Malkin, Eric Staal, Connor McDavid, Tyler Seguin, and believe it or not, one of the most underrated goal scorers in the NHL, the man himself, Anders Lee. I mean, just look at these numbers. 82 games played, 40 goals, 22 assists for 62 points, and he's only 27. Scoring 40 goals is no easy task to do in the NHL, and when you think about guys that do it, you think about some of the most popular and just the best and most lethal guys in the NHL, but literally nobody, and I mean nobody, I hear talking about Anders Lee, and he scored 40 goals, and doing that in an 82-game season is not an easy thing to do, and people discredit him and say, oh, he's just getting feeds off Barzal, Tavares, and Bailey. You can't discredit a 40-goal season. And the thing that impresses me most is he was a 6th-round pick. Getting a 40-goal score in the 6th round of the NHL draft never happens, and for him to be doing that and not getting talked about is just unbelievable to me. A 40-goal score in the NHL that is so underappreciated as Anders Lee, he deserves so much more credit for what he does, and the people that discredit his season saying he gets assists and stuff, he's still putting the puck in the net and you can't take anything away from that, and he deserves so much more credit. The Anaheim Ducks core is getting up there in age, and it's soon going to be time to pass on this team to the next generation of young players, and their future is in very good hands with Rickard Rakell. He is one of the best young goal scorers in the NHL, and in my opinion, he can one day be a Rocket Richard winner. Looking at Rakell's stats for his age, they are very impressive. In 77 games played, he has 34 goals, 35 assists for 69 points, and he's only 24 years old. And I think when the team is more passed over to him and Getzlaff and Perry are no longer the focal point of this team, Rickard Rakell could up that goal total, and I think he could be a 40 to 45 goal scorer and eventually win the Rocket Richard. And I think the Anaheim Ducks are in very good hands with Rickard Rakell, and he's one of the best young players that nobody really talks about in the NHL. He's 24 years old, he still has so much room to grow and learn from Corey Perry, who was a very, very good goal scorer back in his prime. Ryan Getzlaff is still a very good player, but they're both not the players they once were. But they gotta be really satisfied and just knowing when they're gone that the team is gonna be in very good hands. Rakell was drafted 30th in the first round, and for a guy that was taken with the number 30 pick, it's still a first round pick, but the numbers he's putting up at his age are very, very impressive, and the Anaheim Ducks have to be very happy with the turnout they got from him, and I don't really hear enough people talking about him and giving him a lot of credit, and I think he deserves all the credit in the world as the things he's doing at his age are very impressive. For the first couple years of Braden Schenn's career, after he was taken with a high pick, a lot of people were thinking he was going to be a bust like his brother Luke Schenn. But Braden Schenn has really had a coming out party since going to the St. Louis Blues, but he really hasn't been getting a lot of credit, even though he's arguably been one of their best players, because he plays behind already a bona fide superstar in Vladimir Tarasenko. He's been putting up great numbers, and this year was no different. 82 games played, 28 goals, and 42 assists for 70 points. And he's only 26 years old, so he still has a lot of room to grow. But you really never hear people talking about how good of a year Braden Schenn is having. You only hear them talking about Pietrangelo and Vladimir Tarasenko and the superstars on this team. Schenn was taken with the 5th pick, and that is a pretty high pick, and people have a lot of high expectations for you, and some people crumble under that pressure. Obviously, he hasn't made his name with the team that drafted him, but he certainly has made his name as a great NHL player with the St. Louis Blues, and people don't talk about Braden Schenn enough. The run that the Florida Panthers went on towards the end of the season to try to make a push for the postseason was very impressive, and it was led, most importantly, in my opinion, by Vincent Trocheck, and I think he's already a great leader on this team, and he's still young, and that's what's most impressive, and you never hear people talking about Vincent Trocheck. His stats for a 24-year-old, just like Ricard Raquel, are very impressive. In 82 games played this year, he had 31 goals and 44 assists for 75 points, and that's damn near almost a point a game, and that is very good for a 24-year-old. But when you hear people talk about the Panthers, all you hear is them talking about Luongo, Barkov, Ekblad, Huberto, and never really Vincent Trocheck, but he is a very, very important piece to this team, and in my opinion, the future relies around him, Jonathan Huberto, and Alex Barkov, and you never hear people putting Vincent Trocheck in that conversation, and he deserves a lot more credit. Trocheck was an absolute gem of a find in the draft for the Florida Panthers, as he was taken in the 3rd round with the number 3 overall pick, and for him putting up the numbers he does for that kind of pick, and that is kind of why he doesn't get all that recognition, because Barkov and Ekblad and guys like that were really top picks, but a guy that's putting up almost a point a game at a 24-year-old and he was picked that late, he deserves a lot of credit, and he is a very underrated player in this league. So there you guys have it, those are some of the most underrated players in the league in my opinion, and make sure to let me know down in the comment section who you guys think are some of the most underrated players in the league. And remember, this is just my personal opinion, and I hope you guys did enjoy this video. If you did, make sure to smash that like button and subscribe to this channel for more hockey videos like this every single day, and we'll see you guys soon.